interesting number here is the respective heights. Escandon tiny for this division at 5'1.5". Flores extremely tall for the division at 5'9". But what's really interesting, Flores' reach advantage, only 3 inches. You would have thought it would be much larger than that. And because this is a minor title at stake, we have sanctioning body rules. No standing eight count, no 3 knockdown rule. Ref or doctor can stop the fight. A fighter cannot be saved by the bell in any round, and the fight is official after 4 rounds, Barry.
All right, so Escandon, a guy who comes in here off an impressive win. He is 24 up and just 1 down in his professional career. He's got some pop. He's knocked out 16 fighters. He's being trained for the first time tonight by Ruben Guerrero, father, of course, of Robert Guerrero. And oddly enough, Escandon's nickname is Guerrero, which in Spanish means warrior.
Good nickname.
I think so. Escandon has been in there against probably a little bit more experienced opponent than has his opponent tonight, Moises Flores. And that's Guerrero, of course, his trainer, Ruben Guerrero, in the omnipresent hat. Moises Flores, on the other hand, undefeated in his 22 fights. They call him Chucky. And I don't really think he looks that menacing, to be honest with you. Found him to be quite a nice guy. 22-0, he had 1 no contest. He's gotten rid of 16 of his opponents, but has not really been in there against the caliber of opponent that Oscar Escandon has been. So it's going to be a step up for Flores tonight, but I'm looking for an action fight in this one.
No doubt. Different styles.
All right, let's take it to the center of the ring. The introduction of the fighters in our feature fight here on Show Extreme. Here once more is Jimmy Landon Jr.
Ladies and gentlemen, from the StubHub Center here in Carson, California, we present the Showtime Extreme featured bout of the evening, brought to you by Chavez Promotions and Samson Boxing, and sponsored by Corona, la cerveza más fina. This bout is sanctioned by the WBA, the president, Gilberto Mendoza, supervisor, Robert Mack, along with the California State Athletic Commission. Scoring this bout from ringside, all of our judges are from the state of California. From Villa Park, Max DeLuca. From Moreno Valley, Eddie Hernandez. And from Oxnard, Jack Reese. Our referee in charge, he'll be giving instructions after the introductions, Ray Corona. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the interim WBA Super Bantamweight World Championship. Introducing to you first, the challenger on my right, fighting out of the red corner, wearing white trunks with green and red trim, fighting out of Deerfield Beach, Florida, by way of Guadalajara, Jalisco, Mexico. He's 121¼ pounds, his record, 22 wins, no losses, 1 no contest, with 16 wins coming by way of knockout. Please welcome the undefeated WBA number 10 ranked contender, introducing Moises Chucky Flores. His opponent across the ring on my left, fighting out of the blue corner, defending his title, wearing tiger striped trunks, hailing from Ibagué, Colombia. His weight, 121¾ pounds. His record, 24 wins, 1 loss, 16 wins coming by way of knockout. Here is the WBA interim super bantamweight world champion, introducing Oscar Escandon. A referee in charge. Once again, he is now ready to give instructions, Ray Corona.
Mapis, doctor. Mira. It's a little high, guys.
Yeah, high.
A little high, so right here will be good. Okay? Aquí está bien, aquí, mira, aquí está bien. Touch gloves, God bless.
Once again, a look down at the StubHub Center as the crowd filters into this arena. Always have very good crowds for boxing here in Southern California, particularly here at the StubHub Center. And we are set to go round one of this 12-round fight.
Listo! Listo!
Should be an action fight.
Escandon's certainly an action fighter. He's a little tank. And when you were watching the referee, Ray Corona, give the final instructions, you saw dramatically what a difference there is in height. Looks like an NBA center and a point guard standing next to each other.
Escandon starts out immediately with a couple of chopping left hands and has Flores in retreat. Flores just not able to get set right now early in this fight. I don't think he's been hurt by any of this. Escandon, a looping left hand. And a combination from Flores. Not sure Flores was really looking for Escandon to be that quick out of the box.
Well, this is a big step up for Flores, and he's got to get rid of those first round jitters. We're not, he's undefeated, but we're not sure how good he is.
Both these guys with pretty good amateur careers. Escandon, a member of the Colombian Olympic team in Athens back in 2004. Flores had 180 amateur fights. A hooking left hand from Escandon, great weapon. There's a right hand.
And after starting with a lot of movement, Flores not moving very much at all now, standing in the pocket.
Flores with a right hand. So we'll see if Flores has weathered that initial storm. Good right hand again from Flores and a left hand behind it. Flores, a little bit of holding and hitting there, but hey, if it works.
And you see the way Flores is fighting. He has the mentality of a puncher.
Well, he said when he was fighting in Mexico, he was a much more aggressive fighter. Since he's been here in the United States, he wants to see what his opponent's got before he starts with being an aggressive guy. Right hand just a little short from Flores that time.
Flores loading up.
Yeah.
You have to make Escandon move a little bit. You have to make him change angles. Escandon's last fight against Tyson Cave, Escandon got the decision. It was widely considered a bad decision, but Cave never stopped moving, and it frustrated Escandon.
Escandon, you can see, throws punches from all kinds of angles. Nice uppercut from Flores and a right hand over the top. Talk about an action first round.
Escandon will throw that Joe Frazier left hook where he leaps off the ground. That's because he can't reach his opponent if he doesn't do it.
I was just going to say. Damn, the last part of this round, very competitive. Good right hand from Flores.
Yeah, Flores has settled down and gotten into this fight.
Another good right hand from Flores. And another one. Well, I'll tell you what, if that first round is indicative of what's going to happen, we're going to have a heck of a fight here.
Off the stairs. No, back up.
And the keys to victory will begin with Oscar Escandon. He can't take any time off. He has to constantly press forward. The much shorter Escandon can bring Flores down to his size with a body attack. And he can't reach. Sometimes Escandon, you saw it in the first round, he overextends with his right hand. That leaves him open for counters. And for Moises Flores keys, if he stands still, he could get steamrolled. We saw that in the first 30 seconds. He has to keep moving. Land the right. If Flores needs to catch Escandon at the end of his long right hand. And Escandon punches wide. If Flores punches straight, his shots could connect first. He did that in round one.
And he did land the right in round one also. I would have to think that that would be a confidence building round for Flores, because he took care of the assault initially by Escandon, and then he was the guy that was dishing it out at the end of the round.
Yeah, I agree with you, Barry, with the exception of that first 30 seconds, which was all Escandon. That was Flores' round.
Exactly. So now we'll see where it goes. You can see that was a leaping left hand from Escandon and a three-punch combination from Flores. Flores does a pretty nice job of pulling the head of Escandon down and then throwing the right hand.
You saw that, huh?
Yes.
Throw.
One thing Escandon does not do well in the fights I've seen, he does not counterpunch well.
Good strong body shot from Flores. Escandon along the ropes and Flores just peppering him. There again, he slapped the left hand down and threw a punch.
Yeah, it's like Escandon's on offense or defense, but he doesn't transfer well from one to the other.
Steps in with the right hand of the body, does Escandon. Escandon clearly wants a brawl here. Floyd is very effective with that right hand. Left hand after Escandon got Flores turned. Now this is where Escandon wants the fight, and right here is where Flores wants the fight.
And because Escandon, Barry, doesn't counterpunch, he allows Flores to extend that left hand to kind of just leave it there as a measuring stick.
A good left hand from Flores. Counter right hand from Escandon. Flores throwing some lead uppercuts inside a minute remaining here in round two.
Escandon throwing that hook, and it seems like he grazes Flores with it. He hasn't landed it flush much.
There was that uppercut again. It snapped the head of Escandon back.
Well, Flores picking the right punches because he knows exactly where Escandon's going to be and what he's going to do. He just stands there with his gloves, with the earmuffs on.
That uppercut is really being a weapon. He's also thrown some pretty good body shots as Flores in this round. I think by and large, Steve, a very good round for Flores.
Yeah, I'll buy that.
Flores walked right into a right hand from Flores, or rather Escandon did. And again, a combination from Flores, two punches and he's out of there.
Bien bonito. Juega ahí, ponme esto aquí abajito. Lindo. Perdón. Okay, eso está bonito. Necesita llavear un poquitito.
Action from round two. Flores picking his shots. Dips down, and when he comes up, look what he comes up with, an uppercut right between the guard. Again, he knows where Escandon's head's going to be. Escandon doesn't move that head, and he keeps the gloves up. So the key is to punch either around the guard or in between the gloves. And he's doing a good job of punching in between the gloves, especially with that right uppercut that Barry's been pointing out.
Working. We got to win all these rounds. Hard, hard, so you can take them down.
Round three, action fight. Flores in the white trunks, Escandon in the black. Escandon wants an inside fight. Flores would prefer it at a bit of a distance.
One of the keys to this fight, Barry, is that Escandon's been 12 rounds a couple of times. This is a scheduled 12. Flores never been past 7 rounds. So he's moving up not only in quality of competition, but in rounds as well.
Yeah, that could be a factor as this fight goes on. Although the sun is starting to set now, so the heat here at StubHub Center is not going to be quite as much of a factor as it was in our first fight. Flores, again, continue to be very sharp. He has Escandon covering up on the ropes. And now Escandon tries to fight off the ropes, and Flores does a pretty good job to get out of harm's way.
Somebody should tell Escandon he's supposed to pin Flores against the ropes.
Flores catching a lot of Escandon's punches on the elbows and the arms.
Yeah, Escandon's favorite punch is that right hand to the body. You're going to hit an elbow every once in a while when you throw that punch.
You know, what strikes me, Steve, is Escandon is trying to make this an ugly fight, and Flores is just not letting him.
A subtle movement from Flores, too, when Escandon winds up. You know when Escandon's going to punch because he rears back with his shots.
There's a nice three-punch combination from Flores, and there's that uppercut again. And there is he holding the head down and hitting with the right hand. And now he has Escandon looking right into the sun. One minute left, round three. Good body shot from Escandon.
We've seen a little bit of role reversal here, Barry. It's as if Escandon is the fighter who wants to get away when they're on the inside.
Yeah, it's interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, Flores is forcing the infighting.
Three body shots from Escandon and then an uppercut from Flores. Chopping left hand from Escandon.
No,
Good body shot from Flores. And another one with the right hand.
That's Cam Jones just giving Flores too much freedom to punch where he wants and when he wants. Another good round for Flores.
Yeah, very effective, I think. There's a chopping right hand from Escondo in the back of the head. Escondo now on the attack again, but perhaps too little too late in that round.
Now you're doing it. This is what I want now. You need more pressure on him. You need to pressure him. You need to pressure him. This is what we came for here for. You understand? This is what we came for.
Take a look at action from round three. I talked about role reversal. You would have thought it would be the smaller Escandon pinning Flores to the ropes. Not the case at all. And uppercut after uppercut, Flores has found success with that punch. He's being given free shots and he's taking them. And even if he doesn't land all of them clean, that left hook landed pretty clean. He's going to impress the judges enough to win the round. Escandon with his moments as well. A big overhand right knocks Chuki off balance.
But that was at the end of the round, and I believe Flores did enough to win the round. At least the Y card did. They want more pressure from Escandon, and he tries to give him that.
Well, Escandon has to find another gear.
There's that leaping left hand again. Flores gives Escandon, there's a nice right hand from Escandon. Flores gives him just enough movement.
Barry, this pace is pretty fast. And again, Flores never been past seven. I wonder if part of Escandon's strategy is to try to win this fight in the second half.
Yeah.
He started slowly against Tyson Cave and came on a little bit in the middle and late rounds.
Yeah, there's a lot of punches being thrown here. A combination from Escandon.
Nice footwork there by Flores. Escandon pinned him. Flores spun out. That's something Escandon is not doing.
High volume rate. There's a lunging right hand from Escandon. Escandon much busier in this round. Not really allowing Flores to get set. Four punches, but not much doing there from Flores. A winging right, and then he missed the uppercut. And there's the uppercut, got in with the left hand.
And referee Ray Corona allowing Flores to use his left forearm when Escandon's on the ropes to set up shots.
Just like cat fighting him there. Still doing that, kind of pawing at him. 1 minute remaining here, round four. Remember, a 12-round fight here.
It's been a better round for Escandon than the second and third were, that's for sure.
That was caught on the gloves. Caught hard on the gloves.
Hey, la cabeza, cuidado los dos.
Four punch combination from Flores. Flores missing a little more in this round. And there again, he knocks the glove down of Escandon. That throws a right hand, a left hand.
Again, fast pace. I'm going to be looking for signs that Flores is slowing down as he's going to start to push his punches. It's early in the fight, but very fast pace. He could slow down.
Well, he's not quite as effective in this round. I thought a better round for Escandon.
That's how you close the round. That's the way. Nice one. Open up the legs. Nice one. You're going okay. That's the one. That round was tight. It was tight. But we're going to keep going with the jab, and we're going to keep putting him back. He's going to throw, or you have to throw? The uppers. Everything that we worked. Listen to me. This is your fight. Well, how do you want it? On top of him. Let's go. To win it. Hard. Hit him hard. He doesn't have anything left.
Round five, and I'm not quite sure I agree. I think Flores may have a little something left here.
I hope he does. It's only round five.
Yes.
But he did slow down just a little bit in that fourth round.
And was missing a little bit more. Flores scouted Escandon pretty well. Remember, he told us he throws a lot of wild punches, almost bolo-like punches. That's exactly what he's done here.
Why does Escandon allow Flores to do what he's doing with those overhand rights? All he's got to do is step inside when Flores starts that right hand, and he'll be in position to answer. Instead, he gives him free shots.
Good body shot from Escandon, left to the head. Body shot in return from Flores, and another.
Just for a second there, Flores turned southpaw. Yeah. May have been just off balance.
Stop. Stop. No, no, no. No haces eso.
And a right hand in close quarters from Flores.
Yeah, these stretches where Escandon doesn't do anything could end up costing a big time on the card.
Yeah. I think your point is very well taken. It seems to me that the late rounds are going to decide this fight.
I think so, Barry. The question is Flores winning enough of these rounds to build a lead? And here we see Escandon where he's been for portions of this fight against the ropes.
That uppercut's still there for Flores.
This is a pretty close round.
Those wild misses can take more out of a fighter than a punch that connects.
I just see a little less off on the punches of Flores now. Now, of course, we're toward the end of a round, so you could be getting a little tired, but.
Four punches all got there from Flores.
Close round, Barry. Very close round.
I agree, it was a close round. You can see the view from the sky here of the StubHub Center. As we said, it's not only a boxing ring. As a matter of fact, where we are located here is actually, there are tennis courts underneath. They have a tennis tournament here every year. They play some collegiate tennis here. They've had track and field championships here. They've had the California State High School Football Championships in what is the soccer stadium, as you can see on the right side of your screen. And there's a soccer game later on tonight, the Galaxy playing there. And here is Andrew Fonfara. He will be on Showtime Championship Boxing in our main event against Julio Cesar Chavez Jr. That's going to be an excellent fight, I think.
Going to be an action fight, two action fighters. And a lot of people pick Fonfara to win this fight. He's the bigger guy, taller guy, longer reach, and the natural light heavyweight.
Now, we saw him on our Showbox series, and we were very impressed with him his last fight in Chicago. Meantime, we come to round six. Little bit of swelling under the right eye of Flores.
Chucky, I love saying that.
Chucky, yeah.
Chucky Flores.
It's from Chucky, the horror movie, of course, and I don't think he bears any resemblance to John Gruden at all. That was a good right hand. I think that bruise under the right eye of Flores is going to be something that corner's going to want to keep an eye on. Escandon pot shotting a little bit more here in the sixth round.
Good job by Flores, keeping a little bit of an arm's length when Escandon's against the ropes. Allows him to take some free shots, and he could step out if he sees Escandon punch back.
Yeah, two body shots, and then he just peppers the face of Escandon. Nothing serious, but they all got there. Another combination from Flores, and a good left hand from Escandon.
Barrett never thought Flores could compete in a physical sense in terms of strength with Escandon, but if anything, I think he's been the stronger physical fighter.
I agree with you. Midway through round six, and I tell you, virtually every round has been an action round.
It's been a physical fight, and you think in the long run that would be a big advantage for Escandon.
That's going to be interesting. I think you have to remember, and you pointed out earlier, Steve, that Flores has only got 7 rounds. This fight scheduled for 12. I don't think either man has really been hurt. Although, there's one that he almost came out of his shoes. And I would have to think each man has felt the other one's best.
Well, it's not just that Flores has been competitive with Escandon, it's how he's been competitive. He's doing it by fighting him. Not using the ring much.
No, in fact, he's fighting him in his own game in close quarters. Pitting him up against the ropes. Another close round here, Steve. There was an uppercut with the right hand by Escandon.
Yeah, good comeback. Flores started the round very, very strongly.
Two body shots from Escandon and a left hand of the body by Flores. Uppercut missed, right hand counter punch by Escandon, didn't miss. Three shots to the body and a right to the head by Flores. Another very close round.
Okay, ahí vas. Ahí va, ya vas cogiendo tu ritmo, okay? Ahí vas cogiendo tu ritmo ya. Tranquilito. Tranquilito.
Action from round six. And left hook to catch is nothing but air.
If he was playing baseball, that'd have been a balk.
Later in round six, on the inside, you think Escandon would have the advantage, but he allows Flores to reach with those big hooks and right hands because he doesn't counterpunch. And some big misses as well as some big hits in round six.
Buena pelea, buena pelea, huh?
So we reached the midway point of this 12-round fight, and there is not much to choose between these two. I've got this fight dead even right now, Steve.
As I do, 57-57 after six.
Leaning on each other a little bit early in the seventh round.
Once again, this is a 5'1" 122 pounder against a 5'9" 122 pounder. You're not going to see a matchup like that very often.
No, although both fighters say, Flores says, I fought a lot of short guys, and Escandon says, I fought a lot of tall guys.
Everybody's taller than Escandon, right?
Even me, I love it.
We've seen this several times in the fight, and basically nothing good's coming out of it for Escandon.
He walked away from a long blow. And Rick Roden did not jump in very quickly, and he took a left hand, Flores did, from Escandon.
First rule of the ring, protect yourself at all times. You have no right to walk away.
Body shot from Flores.
I like that Escandon every once in a while throws a jab in there.
Escandon just reached up and boxed his ears. two uppercuts and a left hand miss from Flores. And now I think Flores may at least be, Escandon may at least have his attention. I think Flores might be a little hurt here. Right hand misses. And Flores with an uppercut. Just kind of saw the starch go out of Flores for just a moment. There's a good left hand though. He sat down on that punch. And a right hand from Escandon. Left hand from Flores, who now seems back on his feet.
You know, Flores is the fighter hunched over, bent over at the waist. Maybe the little guy, Escandon, should be using some uppercuts.
There's an uppercut again by Flores.
Barry, I think Flores has outworked him this round.
I think he has too. I thought just for a moment that he might have been hurt. Now he comes back. Good right hand of the body. Good left hand by Flores. And a wild left hand again. I don't know. It's going to be interesting to see. I think Flores' legs might be betraying him a little bit here.
Not so much that he didn't offer a kick there.
No, that's true.
Action from round seven. Escandon against the ropes lands a left under the right elbow. The reason he was able to land that punch under the right elbow is because the punch was low. And Flores looking for help. That's a dangerous thing. All right, you know, referee Ray Corona helped block that left hook. Dangerous time there for Flores. And then at the very end of the round, it gets a little chippy. It hasn't been that chippy. A nice shoulder butt, the right shoulder. Of Escandon and a kick.
There was a little elbow action below the dot too from Escandon.
La esquina. Now.
Let's see if this carries over to round eight.
La esquina. Vámonos.
Round eight of a 12-round fight. It's been a terrific fight so far and a very close one.
And I'm really impressed with Flores. I guess you never can be sure how good an undefeated fighter is, even when he's made that record against subpar opposition.
Well, he certainly stepped up tonight, and he's in a fight tonight.
Escandon just gives his opponents too many free shots.
And their hands are free, so Ray Corona says, go ahead. Crowd boos. I think he did the right thing.
But Corona again is allowing.
That was a good right hand.
He's allowing Flores to use his forearm to set up shots. A lot of referees would not allow that.
Live ebb and flow in this fight. Flores does a good job when he's got Escandon against the ropes, as he does right now. And then as soon as Flores steps back, Escandon is right on him.
Flores getting away with some of those wild misses again for the same reason, because Escandon doesn't take advantage by counterpunching. Escandon does not integrate offense into his defense.
No, you're right. It's one mode or the other. Good body work from Flores. Short with the uppercut. Escandon with a reaching right hand. Not much of that got there, got anywhere. Body shots have been caught in the elbows of Escandon for the most part.
But the work rate clearly in favor of Flores.
Exactly.
You know, Barry, Jesus Cuellar is a fighter we've seen on Showtime. He is a very strong 122-pounder, and Escandon a few years ago went to Argentina, Cuellar's hometown, and just steamrolled him.
Yeah.
I mean, Escandon's a very strong fighter, and Flores is meeting him halfway and not giving an inch.
It's really interesting that Flores is doing a better job when he's got his man against the ropes, and Escandon is doing a better job in the center of the ring. Another very close round. They've all been close. There was a right hand counter punch from Escandón, but it was didn't quite get there. Coming up later tonight on Showtime, it's a terrific card. Our co-feature will feature this guy, Amir Imam. We've seen him on a number of occasions. Very, very tough guy and a bright prospect, Steve.
He's been on Showtime three times. First time he knocked the guy out with a highlight film knockout. The second time he knocked the guy out of the ring. And then last time against Fidel Maldonado, I think there were, what, five knockdowns in the fight, and it wasn't that long a fight. He's a very exciting and promising prospect.
And he's in there with a very tough guy, too, Walter Castillo. He can punch, too, so don't run off to the refrigerator during that fight.
Action from round eight. It started getting chippy at the end of round seven. There's an illegal right hand from Escandón to the kidneys. And then he's propping him up there. Didn't punch, but that's not legal either. They're bending the rules. And Ray Corona has been sort of quiet this fight. Not that many warnings.
So this is round nine. Flores already in uncharted waters. Escandón has been here on three occasions.
Well, there's still a third of this fight to go, and Escandón's not going to slow down. But if we're looking for signs that Flores is decelerating, I haven't seen it.
I haven't either. It's been a tough and damaging fight.
You know, Barry, as we get closer to the end of this fight, if it does go the distance, I'm a firm believer that the kind of punches Flores is throwing, which are longer punches, catch the judge's eye much more clearly, like that right hand, than the shorter punches of Escandón, even if they're not harder.
No, I absolutely agree with you. Well, and I do think, without looking at the numbers, whether or not it can be substantiated or not, it seems to me Flores' connect percentage has got to be a little bit higher. Or at least number of punches connecting. That time he came with the right hand and then turned him and hit him with the left hand, did Flores. Long looping right hand from Escandón. A little bit short with both of those. Good body work from Flores.
Flores just rearing back and letting go with wide shots, and there's nothing coming back. Free punches.
A little bit of desperation, I think, starting to show in Escandón here. Getting a little bit wild. Chopping right hand there. Of course, he started out a little bit wild, too. Not sure Flores still has the steam that he had on his punches earlier in the fight, but he's throwing as many of them.
The pace hasn't really slowed down, no, Barry. That's what's impressive.
Nice combination again, right to the body, left to the head by Flores. There's a right hand by Flores at the bell.
Ese es un round de campeón, ¿viste? Ese es un round de campeón, bonito. Desde que empezó hasta que terminó.
Action from round nine. At the top of the show, when we did our keys, we talked about Moises Flores needing to punch straight and to land the right hand. Well, he's doing that with most of his right hands. They've been very straight punches. Occasionally, when Escandón lifts his guard up very high, Chuki has punched around the guard. But for the most part, his punches have been straight. And that right hand is cocked and ready to fire.
That's a championship round. Let's go. Be alive. Let's go. Want that same round. Here we go, here we go. Let's go. Get out.
Round 10, 9 minutes left in this fight. I'd say Flores looked pretty fresh in his corner, see?
His trainer, Herman Caicedo, got him in tremendous condition.
Flores fighting like a confident fighter right now.
And I'm going to reiterate something I said before. This is a huge jump up in class for Flores. His last two fights were in the USA, but he's never fought anybody close to world class. And they're still going at it. Fast pace. Escandon seems like he knows or senses that he needs to do something dramatic
better. Yeah, that's what I started to see in the last round, I think. A little bit of, not frustration, but desperation.
Yeah, look who's doing all the punching right now.
Yep.
And again, look at that forearm, this time the right forearm arm of Flores. It is not legal to prop up your opponent with your forearm.
He's been doing it the entire fight. Clearly getting the best of it here. And the longer the fight goes on, the greater the gap seems to be.
It's almost as if Escandon is thinking to himself, well, this kid can't keep doing this. He's going to slow down. He's a seven-round fighter. Not the case.
Midway through round 10, and it's just been more of the same thing. Both guys busy. Flores a little bit busier and also more accurate. Two wild left hands missed from Escandon.
Some good body work by Escandon. The best of the fight this round.
A good right hand from Flores. And a nice uppercut from Flores. And the chant is Mexico, Mexico, which of course, Moises Flores from Mexico, living now in Deerfield Park, Florida. Deerfield Beach, I beg your pardon, Florida. There's a right hand from Escandon. He takes a left hand from Flores.
Great action, great stuff. Neither one willing to stop punching.
Escandon, a combination. This is a great round, and another really tough round to score. Still could be there for the taking for either man.
You gotta love the lighter weights, Barry. You got heavyweights don't fight like this, ever.
Absolutely.
Again, Escandon pushed back. If he's resting, he shouldn't be, because he could lose the round doing it.
Yeah, I still think this round is extremely close, even with 10 seconds left. Very close round. Take your pick.
We're down on this fight, okay? You need to win all the rest of the rounds. You got to throw. Don't give him a chance. You're leaving him. You're letting him throw. Don't let him.
Action from round 10. Flores has had success all fight with the uppercut. Props up Escandon with the left forearm, drops the left glove, and that's the result. Punching between the guard. But Escandon did some of his best work in round 10. Every once in a while, the little guy lands a jab. And Escandon with a big right hand. He missed about four punches before he landed that right hand, but the right was right on the button. What he hasn't been able to do all fight is land anything to discourage Moises Flores.
This is round 11. And now, on my card, Escandon would have to do something really special to win this fight.
Yeah, I have Flores ahead as well.
Although, it must be said, there have been some very close rounds. That was a near clash of heads again. Flores still throwing punches. little warning for leading with the head from Ray Corona. He'll push two punches and then throw one with some meaning.
There's the left forearm again.
Yep.
It's enabled Flores to control Escandon on the inside, and it also helps him keep him against the ropes when he has him there.
Again, leading with the head, Flores.
Boy, Escandon's jab's really effective.
There's a nice combination from Escandon, and a very good right hand to finish it.
Yeah, set up by the jab. This is just a battle of wills now, Barrett.
Body shot and a good run from Escandon.
Escandon very consistent with his effort. Yes, he has lulls where he doesn't punch, but he fights pretty much every round the same. And yet Flores has not been discouraged by that at all.
Good right hand. This is one of the more definitive rounds, I think, for Escandon.
Yeah, I'll go with you. I think it's his round so far. How do you like the 5 foot one guy jabbing the 5 foot nine guy?
Yeah.
Remember when Tyson used to do that against certain opponents that he had?
Yeah, another not very big guy for his weight division.
That's an intentional.
There's a good right hand.
Flores led with his head there like it was his glove.
He's been doing that a lot in this round, actually.
But again, no warning from Ray Corona.
Three punch combination, Flores, and a right to the body and a left to the head. Final 10 seconds, good right hand again from Escandon. Flores finishes with some good body work, but I don't think there's enough to win the round.
Yeah, he closed big time, and it was Escandon's round for the first 2 minutes. He did just enough to make it difficult to score.
Again.
Action from round 11. Wide left hook by Escandon, but look at it, what he follows with. I think I said that he landed his jab first. It wasn't a jab, it was a hook. And the right hand thrown straight, not always the way that he throws his punches, but straight there and very effective.
Keep throwing hard, keep throwing hard. Don't give him a chance. You got to come with everything. Everything, there's nothing else you can do. You got to come with everything. Hard, hit hard.
So buckle up. Final 3 minutes, and I expect it's just going to be wall to wall. Flores, the early aggressor. Now here comes Escandon.
You think they're going to throw a few punches this round?
I think there's a chance. And I think both corners probably said, you better go out and get this round just to make sure.
I think they know they're fighting at the stub up. Because
you're right.
Everybody who fights at the stub up gives this kind of effort.
You're right. Not a knockdown. Coming very close to clashing heads here on more than one occasion.
And you see the taller fighter going on the inside with the shorter guy. Normally you'd say that's a bad strategy. It has not been a bad strategy. It's worked for Flores.
It's worked all night for Flores. Good left hand from Flores again. Escandon against the ropes. Now he spins off the ropes. Nobody's going to hang their head after this fight. Somebody, though, is going to take a pretty good sized step forward in the super bantamweight division. Midway through the final round.
A lot of punching, Barry, this round, but not much effective punching.
No, I think Flores has been the more effective of the two. There's a left hand from Escandon, a combination from Escandon.
But you gotta love the pace. This is round 12, and most of the fight has been fought at this pace.
Absolutely, been a terrific fight. Just an excellent fight. 1 minute left.
Arriba, arriba.
Reaching right hand from Escandon. Takes three in return from Flores. The crowd really loving this fight, too, as they should. Final 40 seconds. Combination from Flores. Uppercut misses from Flores. Left hand from Escandon. Combination from Flores. Double left hand from Escandon. Final 30 seconds now. Escandon, right hand. Flores ducked right into it. That's a push. That's not a knockdown. Has not been a knockdown in this fight. Escandon just ran at Flores, who threw a right hand and missed. Escandon gets there with the right hand. Final 5 seconds, and Flores tries to finish it with a flourish. What a fight.
Fans appreciate it. They should all be on their feet. They really should be.
That was a heck of a fight.
Action from the 12th and final round of a corker of a fight. And all fight long, the forearm and elbow of Flores, that time instead of propping Escandon up for a punch, he just shoved him to the floor. But Ray Corona correctly ruling, no knockdown. Going to be an interesting decision.
Yeah, it certainly is. Let's look back on some of the rallies, some of the flurries beginning to end.
Well, the pace of this fight, if you told me beforehand that the pace would be what it was, with this many punches and this much infighting, I would have said, well, Escandon's going to win the fight easily because Flores is a seven-round fighter, never been 15. But Flores found success early with straight right hands and a lot of uppercuts. And surprisingly, Escandon got pinned against the ropes. You see it here several times in the fight. And almost every single time they were in this position, Chucky Flores had an advantage.
Staring into the camera, there he looked like Chucky. Just a terrific fight. It's in the hands of the judges. I thought, Steve, a couple of very close rounds. The seventh round I thought was very close. I gave it to Flores. 10th round I thought was very close. I gave that to Flores, too. I have Flores winning it actually fairly easily. I have him by 4 points.
Okay, I have him by two, so there's only one round difference. I have 15-13. Two veteran judges, Max DeLuca and Jack Reese, scoring this fight, and Eddie Hernandez, 6 years of experience. He's the third judge. It's going to be very interesting to see what they have to say.
All right, so it is in the hands of the judges, and we'll take it to Jimmy Lennon Jr. We'll make it all official and find out. Here's Jimmy.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 12 rounds of action, here are the score totals. Judge ringside Max DeLuca sees it 116 to 112 in favor of Moises Flores. Jack Reese scores about 115 to 113 in favor of Oscar Escandon. And Eddie Hernandez scores about 116 to 112 in favor of the winner. And now, the new interim WBA Super Bantamweight champion, Moises Chucky Flores.
I thought a well-earned win.
And I think he deserved the win. Was it a close fight? Yes. But the best moments in the fight were Flores's, and I think he deserved it.
I feel the same way, so we're going to see him again. And I think, quite honestly, we'll probably see Oscar Escandon again, too. His record now 24 up and 2 down. And for Moises Chucky Flores, he runs his record to 23-0. And another one of those names you just might want to tuck away in the back of your mind, because I have an idea you're going to be hearing it a little bit more amongst the lower weight divisions. He wins the interim super bantamweight title. Let's take a look at the scores once more. Two of the judges scoring at 116 to 112 for Flores. And one judge had it 115, 113 the other way.
And Barry, we've just learned that the judges scored the last two rounds for Escandon, but he was too far behind and it wasn't enough.
All right, a wrap for us on Show Extreme. Let's take it back upstairs to Brian Custer. Brian.
All right, Bear, thank you very much. Congratulations to Flores. Those guys gave full effort.